A common phenomenon in software implementation is the system can't do that, or it won't let us do that, or it won't work for this, or it won't work for that, or it won't work for our company. In fact, 6 years ago, when we implemented an entirely new tech stack, everything from accounting to help desk to project management to CRM, literally everything was overhauled and put into a new system, we frequently heard that message almost every day. Nah, I won't do that. Nah, I can't do that. No, it won't do that. And that's a very frustrating thing to hear, okay? Because you've just made an investment in a system that you're fairly confident is going to move your business forward into the next generation, and all of a sudden it doesn't work for your business. Well, it can be a couple of things. Number one, the best case scenario is that you're trying to adapt the software to your processes instead of lifting yourself out of your business for a minute and working on your business and saying, do our processes make sense for the way this modern system wants to work? That's question number one. Question number two, if you still can't figure that out, is do I have the right people in the right seats? The reality is that there's a lot of folks out there who don't want to change, or they see the impact that massive change will cause. And there's no harm and no foul in that. You can be as forward-thinking and, you know, moving your business as forward as you want to, as fast as you want to, and you can be very complacent and happy with where you are in life. I don't fault anybody for wanting and choosing to not change. So do you have the right people in the right seats? And then the least likely culprit is the software can't actually do that. You know, no software is perfect. There's always that 5%, 6%, maybe even 10% in some cases that the software just won't do or won't do right now. And that's why product feedback is super important to the manufacturers. So if it doesn't do something that you expect it to do or that you need it to do, then you're providing that feedback to them so that they can get that in the roadmap and their pipeline and their development. So that's in a nutshell it. If you're experiencing that, you know, can't do this, won't do this, won't work for our company, then likelihood that you need to step in as a leader and figure that out and really understand whether or not, hey, are we just trying to adapt the software to our processes? Because that's ultimately not the goal. We want to improve our processes. We want to take our processes so that they're, you know, applicable for the next 5, 10, 20 years type of thing, instead of looking back 20 years ago when somebody put in place that process that we think is proprietary. And the second thing is do I have the right people in the right seats? Implementing new technology can be disruptive. If you've ever implemented something, let me know how it went. Was it disruptive? Was it, you know, easy breezy? Was it, you know, challenging? Let me know down in the comments and we'll engage in a conversation. So hey, thanks for watching, and as always, make it a great one.